give you love that's above and beyond the call of love, and I'll never ever make you cry. Yes, I'll give you love that's above and beyond the call of love, and love's something that money can't buy.
Harlan Howard, the Dean of Nashville Songwriters, had already tasted great success with his song Above and Beyond when Buck Owens took it to number 3 on Billboard's country singles chart in 1960, where it stayed for 4 weeks. Howard had written Above and Beyond not too long after moving to Nashville and was pleased when he heard that Rodney Crowell was going to remake the song for his big-budget Columbia album Diamonds and Dirt in 1988. Crowell told Harlan that the idea was for it to also be released as a single, and upon hearing Rodney's completed version, Howard predicted a top 5 finish, not quite ready to really go out on a limb and predict a number 1 landing. In fact, Rodney had planned all along for Above and Beyond to be the very first single issued from the album, but things didn't turn out that way. Time went by and 4 other songs from the project had already been selected by Columbia as singles, all 4 becoming number 1 hits, but Above and Beyond still hadn't been, so Harlan had pretty much given up on his song making the national playlists again. The old tune, nevertheless, had been initially earmarked for a very special purpose. Crowell's co-producer Tony Brown's intention was to make Above and Beyond the album's centerpiece in order to provide the project with a direction. They recorded it first on purpose, to set the mood and tone of the album. That way, the rest of the songs wouldn't take too big of a departure from mainstream country, which had been revitalized in a big way during country music's neo-traditionalist movement of the late 1980s, spotlighting such stars as Randy Travis, Ricky Van Shelton, Clint Black, Keith Whitley, Vern Gosden, Dwight Yoakam, and, of course, King George Strait. Rodney Crowell was 9 years old in 1960 when he learned to sing Above and Beyond by listening to Buck Owens' hit record. Years later, he became a good friend of songwriter Harlan Howard, even teaming up with him to co-write a number one hit for Highway 101 called Somewhere Tonight. At about the same time, Crowell's Diamonds and Dirt album was in the planning stages, and it was then that Rodney told Harlan that he would be cutting Above and Beyond for it and would also be campaigning for Columbia to issue it as a single. When the label held back, Buck Owens himself even gave some passing thought for a time about remaking his own hit. Finally, Crowell's version hit the streets in June of 1989. The Diamonds and Dirt album had already produced 4 number one singles, tying it with Earl Thomas Conley's 1984 album Don't Make It Easy For Me for the most chart toppers from one package. The 4th single, After All This Time, had also set a personal record for Rodney, making him the first artist to write, produce, and perform 4 number one hits from the same album. After Above and Beyond reached Billboard's summit on September 23, 1989, the Diamonds and Dirt project then stood alone as producing the all-time number of chart-topping singles with 5, a mark which still stands today. One last footnote. In a recording career that spanned the years 1978 to 2003 and saw 25 singles charted, Rodney Crowell notched a total of 5 number one hits, and all 5 came from the Diamonds and Dirt collection.
Yes, I'll give you love. That's a fun. And beyond the call of love, and love's something that money can't buy.